What's going on, everyone? Juice Bags here, and welcome back to some Dungeon Defenders 2 and another Defense Spotlight. People have been asking me about this one for a few weeks, and it is time to take a look at the mighty Squire's Ballista. Now, first things first, I've been very upfront with everybody. The reason I haven't used ballistas over the last several years, people ask me on live streams all the time, and I've always told them. And the reason I haven't really embraced the ballista over the last several years, really up until recently, is 100% because of Dungeon Defenders 1. The harpoons in Dungeon Defenders 1 were a thing of might and beauty, and going from that harpoon to a DD2 ballista, the second I saw them, I just didn't like them. I wanted that rapid fire that we had in DD1, and DD2 just does not offer that type of ballista. Now, with that being said, you still cannot deny their extreme power, as the ballista is without a doubt one of the most powerful physical defenses there are in the game. Let's go ahead and hop on in and take a look at the ballista setup that I've been using throughout all the way into higher onslaught floors. Now, I go with anti-melee, piercer servo, and anti-orc servo. Now, of course, the anti-melee and the anti-orc are going to stack on top of each other in a multiplicative fashion, not an additive fashion. So you're not getting 151% damage against a melee orc type enemy. That is going to multiply. So first the 51% would come in, and then you're going to get an additional 60% damage if, say, the enemy is an orc. An additional 60% of the 151.09% damage that is already there. So the damage with stacking anti-mods, the damage stacks up very, very nicely. Now, there's really only one required mod for the ballista. You can use any other mods you want. I've seen people use anti-melee and melee boom very effectively. I've seen people use anti-melee, anti-chaos, anti-melee, anti-mini-boss, anti-melee, and anti-range. The sky is the limit. You can use any other mods you want, but you're gonna wanna have piercer servo on it. Of course, piercer servo is gonna pierce the shields of the vanguards, it's going to go through the geode bubbles, and it's going to help you out on those bullet sponge lanes in onslaught. Now, I personally would probably rather have anti-chaos here. Anti-melee, piercer, and anti-chaos to me would be the ideal setup. However, we are all at the mercy of RNG, and I just didn't have a good anti-chaos mod to put on it, and I had a whole bunch of anti-orcs. So I figured, why the heck not? Let's kill all of these big orcs. Now remember, anti-melee and anti-orc is going to apply to regular orcs, cyborgs, berserker orcs. It's going to cover a lot of those main orcs that can give you a problem. So since they're melee mobs and anti and orc mobs, these two anti-mods are just going to wreck it up without a doubt. Now, as far as shards go, I'm using Destruction, Splody Harpoon, and Defense Rate. Now, one thing about Splody Harpoon, I get a lot of people asking me, well, you know, people have stopped using melee booms or boom servos as often because the boom damage kind of falls off as it doesn't scale up in higher onslaught. An important thing to remember about the Splody Harpoon is it is going off every hit. So it is not a on kill, it is every time it hits. It's going to give that additional 920% damage when gilded, or having a 34% chance of detonating for 920% damage every time it goes off. So good, it just stacks up the damage. Now, remember, if you don't have a gilded defense rate shard, you're going to want to use a defense rate mod, because on the ballista, you really want to get down to the speed cap. The speed cap on the ballistas, of course, is one shot per second. As you see right next to attack rate, it says it is the max there. So you're really going to want to get down to that one shot per second. If you do not have a gilded defense rate shard, then you will without a doubt use a defense rate mod in its place. Now, a regular defense rate shard and just about any quality, even a 1 of 10 defense rate mod, is going to either get you right there or get you right at the one shot per second. Now, in this particular situation, if I didn't have that gilded defense rate, I would replace out that anti-orc, as the anti-melee, of course, is going to cover more overall enemies. Now, I don't have any range on here. Now, I'm going with the full range gambit, of course, in your ascension, and I would love to have some more range out of these ballistas. However, as you see, their range is still pretty decent just naturally using the range gambit. Just with the gambit alone and my ancient power, that gets me up to 4650. It's not a terrible range, it's pretty decent. I would love to have this thing shooting way, way down lanes, but I just don't want to give up the additional power that the Splody Harpoon brings me and the additional power from stacking those anti-mods. So once again, in my world, a perfect ballista would be anti-melee, piercer servo, and anti-chaos. I'm happy to go with this because it's just the mods that I personally have. However, play around with your ballistas. There's no doubt it is a super, super powerful defense. It is expensive. It's 60 DU, but remember, it's also piercing enemies. So since it's piercing enemies, you're getting more than just single target damage out of it, and the ballista can get the job done for you, particularly if you combine it with some sort of crowd control, like weapon manufacturers, a frostbite tower, a boost aura with the slow. There's lots of different options. If you add any crowd control to a lane with ballistas, you can just about guarantee yourself a win, as they are just super, super strong and will pierce through the packs. So that will do it for now. Thank you all so much for watching. Get out there and shoot some stuff with some harpoons, because we all know, even though they're not DD1 harpoons, they're still pretty darn good. So thank you once again, and I will see you next time around. Take it easy.